Okay, in this video I'm going to cover your O-rings, your wiper, and your valve. Now in the previous video I showed you how to take off your trigger and your hammer and all the rest of the internals. For those guys, you know, I'll do the usual, I'll post a link for you can go and check it out and get caught up. For the rest of the class, let's continue on. Now, if you notice, mine is nice and clean. Yours is going to be all black and nasty.
Okay, these next pictures are pretty typical what you find when you take everything apart. See on the top here, you usually find a pellet somewhere in there. All the black dieseling, right where the hammer goes, that's especially worst. Right there, you can see it on this picture. All the dieseling, that all needs to be cleaned out. So this is a prime example of that. And this is a bit longer than I expected. And there we go, on the front of your piston tube, you'll get a lot of that. That'll have to usually be scraped
off. Have, you know, pieces of pellets in there, twigs, who knows what. You'd be surprised what you find in these things. So what you need to do is clean it all out. I would suggest using latex gloves, because just like when you work on your car, how you have like the oil on your hands, it takes a couple days to get it off. Same thing, or takes hours of scrubbing. You'll get the same problem with this. So make sure, just wear some gloves on that. When you clean everything out, make sure you clean everything out. Your hammer, right? Hammer needs to be cleaned off. Clean off all the crap on your hammer. The trigger, all the internals, the trigger and everything. And make sure you clean the body too. Clean it all out. One part I don't want you to forget is right here. This is your pump tube. Clean your pump tube out just like that, so it's like looks like it's brand new, right? Clean it all out. The reason for that, the reason I want you to clean it all out is one, the internals will work much smoother. If you have the hammer hitting the valve cleanly, right, you'll get a nice, better airflow. The second reason is people use all the wrong type of lubricants. You know, they're using everyone's favorite spray-on lubricant. First, you know, here's an O-ring that's been soaking in it. And if you look here, it's actually bigger. Yeah, that black on black works great. Okay, if you look here, right, it's actually a little bit larger. It's actually larger than the other O-ring. And you might think, well, that's great. I'm going to get a tighter seal. And the O-ring's going to work much better. Well, yeah, no. See, what happens, first of all, I know this is used with a lot of organizations for target shooting, teach kids. You know, the Canadian cadets use it. If you have everybody spray on lubricant and it expands the O-rings, you have 100-pound kids trying to cock this thing while the everything is all, you know, expanded inside the tube. It's going to be much harder to pump. It's going to be much more pressure for the kid to move that. And they're going to waste a lot of energy just trying to pump the air rifle when it's not really needed. You don't need a super, super tight seal. That's the biggest mistake people think. You don't need a super tight seal. You need a good seal, but not super tight. Here's another O-ring. This is an O-ring I pulled out that everyone's spray-on lubricant was used. And after a while, I hope it shows up, but it's actually pretty flat around the outside. So you get a nice tight seal and it's actually probably too tight of a seal. The O-ring starts to wear away, and then all of a sudden you have an O-ring that is completely, it's all worn out. Okay? And that's actually counterproductive. Okay? So there's that. That's why you don't use that. People like to use gun oil. Don't use gun oil. These are not guns. They're air rifles. They work differently, different stresses, different, you know, heat. You know, you don't have to worry about an air rifle cooking off, right? So you don't have to, don't use gun oil. People like to try all these different things like graphite. Don't use graphite. You're trying to. I've seen graphite so many times. You don't need graphite. All you need is heavyweight 30 motor oil. Buy it in the automotive department. Get yourself, right? Put it in a little container like this where you can administer the oil where you need it. This works great, works fine. The other lubricant you're gonna need is white grease. I get a small thing. You don't need the huge tub. You see these huge tubs? You don't need them. Just get the small one, okay? The small little container. So, clean it all out. Make sure that you clean everything, all right? Okay, now that we've removed all the dieseling, it's time to work on the O-rings, the wiper, and the valve. To do this, you have a couple of options. First one, my favorite, is the dental tool. This is really great for help taking out the O-rings. The next is, this is actually called an O-ring removal tool. You can find them at any hardware store. This is your second choice. And the last choice is basically a small blade knife. The only problem with these is they tend to nick the plastic, and if you nick the plastic, it might, over time, cut away at your O-ring. So just be careful when you're using these. So first thing we need to do is basically get rid of our O-ring. There we go. First O-ring gone. All right, then get rid of our wiper. Now, the reason I'm telling you to get rid of your wiper is because, remember I mentioning that people use the wrong lubricants? Well, those wrong lubricants have a second problem, that is they usually cause more dieseling. So, I don't know if I mentioned this, make sure you clean out the rifle. Okay, good. So clean it all out, and that's how you deal with your piston, and now we're gonna deal with your valve right here. Okay. So, first remove the top cover. Now, there is a spring under there, so just be careful. It's not under a lot of tension, but it is there. There we go, and remove. Your spring and your valve should come out all at once. If it doesn't, just put it upside down, right? Just all you need to do is push in from this end, and it'll pop right out. Right, so that is that out. And then, now that it's out, it's easier to deal with the O-ring there. It's easier to deal with the O-ring there, yeah. Okay, so there we go. There we go. It's out.
Okay, thanks for watching. In the next video, I'll show you how to put the O-rings and the valve back in. The valve's a little bit more tricky than you might think. And as usual, you know, subscribe, check out the more videos on the channel, and also BBGunRepairHQ.com.